Logan Lindo here with Lance Blanks. Shipley McCoy in the house as well.
Yeah, baby.
These guys know about putting up points. And Texas did that.
Donuts.
Against Baylor. Jackson Hayes, some authority early on. Texas went to work inside.
Yes, they did, man. They were like a Rubik's Cube for Baylor to try to figure out. They were getting it from everywhere, Lowell. The big fellas took over early. No double team. Guess what? Then I'll throw it right over the top.
Matt Coleman was electric, 14 points in the first half.
Yeah, he controlled the game in the first half. He knocked it down from the perimeter. He was very poised. Guys were going under screens, and he made them pay for it. But he was also getting to the basket, as you know, and shooting the little runner. And the speed, though, look at that, 4.15. Looks like a little NFL pre-draft on the hardwood.
Then you got Courtney Ramey. And he was active defensively, to say the least.
Ramey!
Ramey?
Beyond the arc. A little high pitch action. But then he did a little bully ball, too. Look at that young fella getting it done.
10 points for Courtney Ramey. Baylor, meanwhile, tried to mount the comeback and got within 8 points in the second half. But Texas was able to respond. Jace Febris was the big part of the response.
Yeah, but first, Baylor had to send out some posters with the little fellas getting to the rim, doing a little nice passing, slicing and dicing. But to your point, Texas treated it like a boxing match, and they responded and came off the ropes swinging.
Febris, three balls all of the second half.
Febris was a big deal from beyond the arc, and these guards knew where to find him. He was like a magnet man on the perimeter with the ball.
Just like the one against Kansas, when Texas needed a bucket to answer, Febris delivered. Horns win 84-72.